We're at Lutheran High School, where tonight the Crusaders host Kohler. Hello, everybody. My name is Mike Martin. Joining me is the coach, Chris Wright. Last game of the season, Chris. It seems like we just got started.
No, it's really a strange year. This year, the boys' tournament before the girls' tournament. We're only at, you know, Valentine's Day, and this is it. And tournament's next week, and by, you know, next week, Saturday, you're going to be, you know, half the teams in the state will be out of the tournament already. I mean, it's not even close to March yet.
Yeah, next Saturday is regional final day, and then they go into two sectionals. Lutheran and Kohler are both going to be playing on Tuesday. North will be covering that game, plays next Friday. But let's talk a little bit about tonight's game. Kohler comes in at 8-13, only 4-11 in conference. Lutheran has second place sewed up. They're 12-3 in conference, 14-7 overall. What does Kohler offer on their side of the ledger?
Well, it's a very strange conference this year. I was looking, if you look at the front four teams, they all won like 10 games or more, and then it's a drop off to like five. It's kind of a strange situation. At Kohler this year, there's...
You know what you'd call it, Coach? The haves and the have-nots. And we got a have, and we've got a have-not tonight.
Right. It appears that way. You got Kohler, who's been on the bottom of the conference for the last couple of years, trying to make that kind of build back up together. And Coach Rader trying to, you know, build something to get back to the top of where Kohler's always been. And you got a very young Sheboygan Lutheran team that's basically, you know, got second place wrapped up and done an excellent job. Both teams going for postseason play. But, you know, like I said, been a very strange conference this year. And the last time they played at Kohler, it was Kohler leading up through three quarters until Sheboygan Lutheran just kind of made Kohler run out of gas. The Jets kind of ran out of gas, I guess you could say. And that was too much for Kohler. But it was an excellent basketball game for the first three quarters. I hope we get that tonight.
Now, talking about turning the Jets on in the fourth quarter, Tyler Zastrow had no points through the first half and really didn't start scoring until late in the third quarter, and he ended up with 21 points. He needs to get it going a little sooner tonight.
Yeah, he's going to be shooting. Saw him last week against Christian in an outstanding basketball game, and it was kind of strange, you know. Like you mentioned, he got a lot of shots at the free throw line late. You know, next thing you know, all of a sudden he's at his average at 19 now. He's looking for a conference championship shooting crown, too. He's just behind Josiah Verveldi from Oostburg. He passed him up this week, so don't be afraid to see Zastro shoot some up there.
Now, sometimes you got to be careful with that as a coach, because you still want the kid to be playing team basketball, not just worrying about his individual stats. So it's, I don't want to say it's a fine line, because there really should be no line. You know, you play like a team.
If I was Coach Verhagen tonight would be, I'd be so tough on these kids. I would be extremely tough, because what are they playing for besides Ben, you know, a senior night and things like that? What are we playing for? We're playing to get ready for the tournament. So I'd be so tough on my kids tonight. Any little things and, you know, goof things that they do, sit them down on the bench and remind them why we're successful. Because tonight's one of those games where, like you said, things might just get away a little bit. I want to build momentum. I want to be real strict today, because I want to be tough. Because, I mean, this team has a chance to get some places. You know, I know Green Bay New is in this sectional, and they're real tough. But, you know, we got a nice ball club in Lutheran.
Kohler, kind of the same thing. They play Christian the first round of the tournaments, which should be a very competitive game. And Kohler's got a pretty nice little guard in the name of Dominic Bocchini, whose dad actually played for the state championship team back when the Wolf boys were around.
Yeah, and he's just a sophomore, too. And I was looking at the Kohler roster. They don't have too many seniors either. They're trying to build a little bit. I watched some of the JV team game a little bit, and the Kohler Blue Bombers and Larry Campman, who's been there for, you know what,
forever.
35 years or whatever, got just another win under his belt. But, you know, a lot of the, I think this conference is very young, and I think it's going to be really a lot of fun to see them next year as well. But it's nice to get a sneak preview this year.
All right, with that, we're going to step out, and we come back, we'll have the starting lineups and a tip off for tonight's game.
Did you know that 90% of all eye injuries can be prevented by simply wearing proper eye protection? I'm Dr. Tamara Fountain for the American Academy of Ophthalmology. I see firsthand how vision problems can affect lives. We recommend that every household keep protective eyewear on hand to use during home projects and other activities that can cause injuries. Know your risks. Save your sight. To learn more about eye health, visit geteyesmart.org.
I wouldn't let my peeps drive drunk.
Do you?
Do you?
Do you?
I got one.
Do you?
Actually, I got two. Designated drivers, that is.
Keep your head screwed on straight. Don't drive drunk.
I don't. Do you?
Do you?
Do you?
Don't drink and drive. We don't.
Do you?
Brought to you by Rad, Terry Fader, and My Safe Ride Home. Friends don't let friends drive drunk.
I'm looking for my safe ride home.
Do you?
Green, green, green. It's your home, it's your dream. Rain on testing, keep it healthy and clean. Make it green, green, green.
Making it green starts from the ground up, so make sure the air in your home is healthy for your family to breathe. Test your home for the presence of radon. Go to epa.gov/radon.
Make it green, green, green.
Time was, kids did what came naturally, spending free time running through the grass, exploring streams. But times have changed. Today's indoor kids spend more than 7 hours in front of electronic media. That's why National Wildlife Federation created the Be Out There movement. Outdoor play improves kids' health, body, mind, and spirit. It helps them stay fit, enhances creativity, and could even make them better students. There's a reason they call it the Great Outdoors. Learn more at beoutthere.org.
Be out there!
Lineup for Kohler. Talked about Dominic Bocchini, he's a 5'9 sophomore. Philip Case is a 5'7 junior. Tyler Lewis, 6'3 senior. James Miesfeldt, number 33. And number 35, Brennan Ladwig, is a 6'3 junior. It's senior night here at Lutheran High.
At this time, we introduce the lone senior out of 2012-2013.
We mentioned about how young the Crusaders were. They only have one senior, Ben Leipom.
And
6'5", number 11. There you see him coming out with his mom and dad.
Let the lessons you learn at Lutheran High continue to mold and shape you in your future endeavors. May the Lord continue to bless the rest of your school year and whatever plans He has in store for you.
A nice little ceremony for lone senior Ben Leipom.
And now, Sheboygan Lutheran fans, get on your feet.
Jacob Juris. Ryan Sheely, number 4. Tyler Zastrow, averaging about 19 points a game. Phil Leipom, number 23. And the lone senior, Ben Leipom. Lutheran is coached by Nick Verhagen. Kohler is coached by Ken Rader. Our officials tonight are Dave Kierstead, Jason Nate, and Ty Stoneburner. They're three gentlemen that we have not seen before. And I think part of the reason for doing a three-man crew might be get ready for the tournaments.
Yeah, I think it's up to the officials when they wish to do that, Marty. And tonight's one of the nights they picked it. They got to split the money, though, but I think it's good work for them. You're right. Tell you, Kohler's guards are pretty small, Marty. They're listed at 5'7", 5'9", maybe in their shoes.
You're right there. And we're off and running. Last game of the season for these teams. Four running in the weave to start off with. Shot from three-point land is good by Brennan Ladwig. Good start for the Blue Bombers. Ball lost out of bounds by Leipom. A little bit of a no-look pass, kind of hard to handle, Chris, by Tyler Zastrow. Juris guarding Bocchini. Jump shot in the lane is no good by Case. Zastrow with a turnover. Sheely kept going underneath the basket. He didn't stop like Zastrow thought he was going to. Three-point attempt is up and good by Lewis. Both teams playing a man-to-man defense. Pretty good defense being played by Kohler. And as I say that, Zastrow drives the lane for two. Pretty easy there, Chris, for Zastrow.
Way too easy.
Good defense by Leipom on the baseline to prevent the drive. Bocchini's shot is no good. Sheely with the rebound. And almost thrown away by Juris. Kick out to Leipom. His three is good. Then Leipom. 6-5, Kohler on top.
I think the press here is just to make Kohler work a little harder.
Bocchini at the controls. Driving a kick. Then another extra pass and a shot is no good that time by Ladwig. Crossover dribble by Zastrow. He drives the lane, got it, and then he's fouled.
Well, that's twice he got to go left-handed. That just should never happen. Got to have better defense than that. Force him to his right. But Tyler taking advantage of the situation.
Did the crossover move real nice, Chris. Second time he's done that. All of a sudden, it's 8-6. Lutheran, they've gone on an 8-point run after being down 6-0. Good help by Tyler Zastrow. Bocchini, right-handed shot is no good, and there's a foul. He's going to be shooting a pair. Bill Leipom picks up his first foul. Good shot of Dominic shooting that second free throw, and he missed them both. And then we got a quick foul on Tyler Lewis.
Well, he's complaining, but what are you there reaching in there on that anyways?
I was going to say this game is going to be refereed a little differently than that in that Wisconsin game the other night when they didn't want to call any fouls. The light bomb. Kohler continues with the man-to-man defense. Ben Leipom from outside the line, nails a three.
Let's start shooting for Lutheran. They're 4-4, Marty.
11-6. Bocchini is fouled on the drive. He's going to be shooting a pair.
Crusader foul four, Ryan Sheely.
Ryan Sheely picks up the foul. Bocchini will be at the line again. He was 0-2 just a few seconds ago. Hogan and Fink are in. Fink wearing my favorite number, number 25.
Well, they're the fourth and fifth leading scorers on Kohler, and they both come off the bench.
Well, those free throws breaks the 11-point run by the Crusaders, Chris. It's 11-8. Lutheran on top. Just about halfway done with the first quarter, and now Kohler is sitting in his own. And good interception by Ladwig. And he throws it out of bounds. Boy, it looked like they were cooking, Chris. Had to steal. Looked like they had a number advantage, too, but...
Got to hit your target.
If you're aiming for the wall, you hit it, but he wasn't. He was aiming for somebody in blue. Sheely from the baseline. His shot is off. Bocchini with the rebound. Got a man down, and Hogan not able to handle the pass. And then Lightbaum is tripped. No call. Bocchini's nice pass to Ladwig, and he's got two. 11-10. Sheely goes up high to get it, but he wasn't able to get the shot off. Lightbaum from outside the line nails another three. He has a quick 9 points.
Have a senior night. First 5 minutes. 9 points, three threes.
Ladwig on the travel, tripped. Brendan Ladwig is a 6'3 junior. Well, they put the big guy, Tyler Lewis, 6'3", at the top of the zone. But the Phil Lightbaum takes it in and scores.
Lutheran, 6 of 7 from the floor, Marty.
Good defense by Phil Lightbaum, cutting off the baseline.
Sheely with 4 rebounds. Does a great job of just rebounding and playing good D, number 4, Ryan Sheely. And he can score.
Sheely down the baseline off a nice pass from Phil Lightbaum, scores. They're starting to figure out the zone, Chris.
Well, Kohler just doesn't have the speed that Lutheran has.
Bocchini, a kick out pass to Hogan. His shot is off, or Fink, pardon me. And then the long pass to Lightbaum goes out of bounds. Hey, 22!
Now, you don't mind that turnover. I don't mind that. You know, you're trying to push the issue and, you know, you like to execute it, but it was a good idea. But it is the fifth turnover on Lutheran already.
Wow, that's a lot. And there's still 2 minutes left in the quarter. Sheely had that one red. Step back jumper by Zastro is no good. And driving the lane, but missing was Lewis. Juris with the rebound, kicks it out to Zastro, who lays it off the glass and in. And we got a timeout by Kohler. It's 20-10. Kohler trailing by 10. Lutheran on top, and Ken Rader senses it getting away from him a little bit, Chris.
Well, they don't have the speed enough on defense, and I don't like their shot selection either.
It's not so bad when you're short, but when you're short and slow in basketball, then you're hurting.
Yeah.
Well, I thought they were going to do a little better when they went to the zone, and they did for a couple of trips, but then it seemed like Lutheran started to figure it out.
Well, the goal of the zone is to keep it out of the middle.
And
well,
they keep getting it in the middle.
They get that in the layups. They're giving up layup after layup, and that's why Lutheran's only missed 2 shots all night.
That's the other thing. That's a real killer right there. 1:30 left in the first quarter. Brett Miller snuck in the ball game, and Lutheran with another. Oh, Phil Leipom. That was sweet. Forced back to the middle and just kept control and spun around and made a layup.
Now the turnovers are mounting on Kohler as they got five.
Fadeaway jump shot is no good by Hogan. He gets it in the middle and puts it in.
Well, I just don't like the shot selection by Kohler. They don't get good looks and they just heave it up there.
It was another 11-point run by Lutheran. Finally broken by Hogan's basket.
Blue Bomber foul, 35, Brennan Ladway. First personal, 13. Tyler Zastro at the line to shoot.
Tyler Zastro missed the first. That was the second free throw by Lutheran. Zastro had the first one. He made that one off a three-point play earlier in the quarter. It's 23-12.
Yeah.
8 points for Tyler Zastro. 9 points for Ben Leipom. Shot from outside the line is no good by Case, and then we get a foul.
Crusader foul on two. Jacob Ames, first personal, 13.
Foul goes on Ames. Coming in is Jeff Hess and Taylor Zastro. Case in the lane, shot is no good, and Tyler Zastro is going to pick up the foul.
Crusader foul, 32, Tyler Zastro, first personal, 14 foul.
Well, since Kohler started off with those two threes, they're 2 for 10 since. Plus they've added about five turnovers to that, plus they'll be down by 11.
Yep. They have struggled since that good start. And a foul near half court. We're going to have to see what this is about. Fouls on Case. Both teams sitting with four team fouls. 25 seconds remaining in the quarter. Hess has it on top. Eisenstein also in the ball game now. The Leipom has it tipped away. Good hustle defense by Connor Hogan. The Bombers.
Poor decision by Taylor Zastro to throw that ball there.
That's with a good catch and stop. 7 seconds. 2 seconds. Pass at the buzzer. No good. And we're at the end of one quarter of play. Lutheran on top, 23-13.
Local government, local educational institutions, and local community members all use cable access TV to communicate their message. They depend upon it as an affordable means of outreach. Public educational and government access television empowers local government agencies, individuals, and groups to use the media to speak directly to their constituents in a more direct and cost-effective way. Make sure everyone has a voice. Support your local PEG channels.
The preteen years are a challenging time, but they're also a good time to think about your child's health, which is why, if you're the parent of an 11 or 12-year-old, you need to know about preteen vaccines. Vaccines that can protect your preteen from meningitis, whooping cough, and for girls, the virus that causes cervical cancer. So schedule a checkup for your child today and ask about preteen vaccines, because your preteen might think that they're grown up, but they're counting on you to know better.
Brought to you by DHHS and the CDC.
Hey, there you see Todd and Johnny. Son John. the Deckers. Tough loss for Wisconsin the other night up in Minnesota.
Some tournament. Only get an inbounds pass in.
Yeah, or remember that you're not supposed to run the baseline.
And make a few free throws.
Kohler back to man-to-man defense.
Sam Letterman scoring last night, Marty.
Yeah, 14 points. That's right, that was a Wednesday game, wasn't it?
No, Thursday.
Thursday.
Wednesday. Thursday. Thursday, last night.
Yep, Thursday night. And then I think they play again on Sunday against Ohio State.
Yep.
That'll be on TV. Kohler hustling on the D, and the Crusaders trying to find an opening. Taylor Zastro has it on top. Coach Verhagen calling out a play. I don't know if you can hear him behind us.
Yep, the old number one.
Hasenstein from deep, and it rolls in. They could have gotten that shot about 30 seconds ago.
That's the old North number one play.
Think we're going to drive it in and then shoot from way outside the line. That was a deep three.
That's the offense when Rudolph and Portman were there.
A kiss off the glass by Miesfeldt is in. Zastro got hammered and he put it up and in, no call.
He's got a quick start just as you asked, Marty. He's 4 for 5 from the field, got a couple free throws. Has not attempted a three yet.
Well, Case throws it away and then Hess gets hammered.
6 turnover on Kohler.
Balls on James Miesfeldt.
Lutheran still red hot from the floor. They are 11 of 14 from the field.
Holy cow.
And they've hit all their threes. They're 4 of 4 there. Kohler going to try the zone again.
Skip pass to Hasenstein. He's feeling it. Ozzy with good hustle, kicks it inside to Sheely, who rolls it up and in. 30 to 15, Lutheran on top.
Well, they're playing their zone. Well, I'll explain that on the other end, Marty.
There's a travel not called.
And not a good shot.
The shot attempt was by Brett Miller, and then Lutheran throws it away. Drive down the lane. Hess with a good rebound. Missing the shot was Noah Fink. Good inside feed to Sheely. Off the glass and in. 32 to 15. We have a full timeout. Kerry, let's take a short break and clean up that score. It's 32 to 15. Run in the quarter, Chris. It's now 32 to 15. They're just turning it on now.
Well, 6-0 to start with, and I just don't like Kohler's shot selection, Marty. They just kind of heave it at the basket. They don't really get any clear looks. When they got the clear looks, they made them. But that was a long time ago. There's some of your friends, Marty.
Yeah.
There they are.
Jim Lightbaum's kids. Jim and Holly. Holly's with child. Kindergarten teacher over at Jefferson. Five-minute mark.
Lutheran has definitely picked up the defensive intensity, too, from the beginning of the game.
Kohler trying to get their plays set. That's and just a good hustle by Zastro to tip that ball away.
Just a poor
Chile
pass.
Chile had a good look, but couldn't get it to roll in.
His first miss of the, or second miss of the night.
Bocchini goes through three defenders, kisses it off the glass and in. Nice play.
He's averaging 9 points a game.
He's got four so far, Chris. That's getting pretty much playing time tonight. Jeff, a 6 foot junior. Sheely's shot is blocked, but he gets it back and puts it up and in. I got him with 6 points. Shot on the side is no good. The tip is no good. Hess tips it over to Ben Leifbaum, and it's a 3-on-1. Good little pass to Hasenstein. And another two. Good running of the fast break that time. Dominic Bocchini from 12 got the roll. 36-19.
I think that one hit the wire, Marty. Wait.
It was a healthy shot. Bounce pass is knocked away. Case has it for the Bombers. And we get a kicking violation. Juris and Ames coming in. Sheely working hard. He's huffing and puffing as he goes to his chair.
I like him. He does all the dirty work. 6 rebounds.
Oh, somebody lost track of Brennan Ladwig, and he scored easily, and he's fouled.
You know, I never really guarded the inbounder. My inbound guy, whoever was guarding the inbounds underneath, always his number one role was to protect the basket. So that those type of things don't happen.
Ames picks up his second foul. He hasn't even been in 30 seconds.
Hey.
Ben Leipum picks up another foul.
Crusader foul 11, Ben Leipum. First personal, 16.
Going to the line to shoot a pair will be Tyler Lewis. Lewis hit a three-pointer early on, Chris. It's been silent up until that free throw.
Well, if you're colder, you want to crawl back in here. Half totally dominated by Lutheran.
And he gets a hard roll, makes it go in. Kohler, 36 for Lutheran. Ball is tipped away. Lewis couldn't get the layup in, and then we get a foul. Hasenstein gets fouled by number 33, James Miesfeld.
About the third or fourth missed layup for Kohler.
Yeah, Lewis might have taken off a little bit too far from the basket. Needed to get just a little bit closer. Make it a high jump rather than a long jump. Zastro from outside the line is no good. That was unnecessary. I would get them all too. Hess and Sheely back in. .213 left in the half. The Crusaders up 36-23. Mike Martin along with Chris Wright bringing you tonight's game. Kerry Kautzer is our director. Richard Bartson and Eric Wiesman are on camera tonight. And nice shot and a roll for Brennan Ladwig. Sheely got caught up in the air and tried to throw one in.
And his prayer wasn't answered. And another basket and up and in by Kohler. That one by Miesfeldt. 36-27.
Well, Sheely went in there, and Ladwig didn't even take the charge. He kind of should have been called for a foul, I thought, since he didn't stick in there.
It's a 10-0 run. They were down 36-17. They've run off 10 in a row to crawl right back in. Let's talk a little bit while we have some time about the tournament. Luthern is a number 3 seed in this regional, and they will play Oneida Nation on Tuesday, the 14th-ranked team.
That's who we saw last year here.
Yeah, they weren't very good. That was quite a blowout. We won't be doing that game. On the same night, Kohler and Christian will be playing. Kohler's a 7th seed. Christian is a 10th seed. That's Hoppy right there.
Why isn't
he
dancing?
The Hoppensberger. I don't know. Where is it? He's right behind us. Hoppy. On in the other bracket, North will be playing South on Friday in a rare occurrence. They usually don't play each other right away, but the way the seeding worked out, they will play. And we will be covering that Friday night game. If Luthern wins, they'll play the winner of Thomas Aquinas and Gresham Community. Ames puts the garbage back up and in and breaks the run by Kohler. 38-27, 1:20 left in the half. Juris picks up the loose ball. Oh, Leipum with a great cut, and Phil Leipum gets rewarded with a nice pass from Sheely for an easy two.
The Leipums are 6 for 6 from the floor. Ben has 3 threes, and Phil has 3 twos.
That's pretty amazing. That's 15 points. Case almost lost it. 25, under 20 seconds left now. Kohler playing for one. Oh, wow.
Bonus.
Juris commits the foul. That's his first. Dominic Bocchini will be shooting. There's 16.2 seconds left. Boy, oh boy, that seemed pretty ticky-tack, Chris. I don't know about you.
Yep.
You thought, but.
Seventh rebound for Sheely in the half.
Oh, nice pass inside to Ames, who puts it up and in. Sheely with a good look. And tipped away, and we're at halftime. The Luthern Crusaders up 42-27.
I can have text all night long, but not when I'm driving.
What's the point of texting me about a party that you might not make it to?
I don't text and drive.
Do you?
Do you?
Do you?
Did you say text or sex? Hey, I got an idea. As long as you're texting, why don't you write your own obituary, dumb?
I don't
text and drive.
Do you?
We don't text and drive. Do you?
Brought to you by Rad Terry Vader and his cast of thousands. Friends don't let friends text and drive.
Party!
Did you know early signs of eye disease and vision changes start to occur around age 40? I'm Dr. Ann Coleman for the American Academy of Ophthalmology. I see firsthand how vision problems can affect lives. We are urging adults to get a baseline eye disease screening at age 40. If you have any risk factors or signs of eye disease, see an ophthalmologist right away. Know your risks. Save your sight. To learn more, visit GetEyeSmart.org.
Cable access channels are critical tools for local government. They provide important information about issues, services, and programs, as well as local emergencies. They also allow you to watch your local elected officials in action. Through the provision of governmental access channels, our communities are kept informed, educated, and entertained. Where else can you get information about your local government? Make sure everyone has a voice. Support your local government access channel.
Engineers Without Borders USA answers the call with more than 225 university and professional chapters from a wide spectrum of disciplines. With more than 400 sustainable engineering projects in more than 45 countries, our organization is changing the world. If you would like to find out more about how you, too, can change the world, visit www.ewb-usa.org and click Get Involved. Engineers Without Borders USA, building a better world, one community at a time.
Mia Hamm. As a professional soccer player, I know how rewarding sports can be and how quickly injuries happen. So I've teamed up with the American Association of Orthodontists to ask athletes to play it safe. With my years of training, I know what it takes to become an expert, and orthodontists do too. They're the experts who help people obtain healthy, beautiful smiles. Wear mouth guards, face masks, and helmets to prevent injuries. Keep smiling and visit braces.org.
Back at Lutheran High School, we're getting ready to start second half action. Lutheran leads it 42-27. First half scoring, first for Kohler. Dominic Bocchini had 6, Phil Case 1, Connor Hogan 2, Tyler Lewis 5, James Miesfeld 4, and leading the way for the Blue Bombers was Brennan Ladwick with 9. For the Crusaders, Jacob Ames had 4, Ryan Sheely 8, Nate Hosenstein 5, Ben Lipum 9, Phil Lipum 6, and leading the way was Tyler Zastro with 10. Chris, you'd mentioned some stats. Lutheran shot pretty good that first half.
How about 66%, Marty? And 66% from three-point range as well. They did have 8 turnovers. Kohler, on the other hand, they hit those first two. Since then, they're 8 of 21. They were 10 of 23 in the first half. 2 of 5 from three-point range. They have 9 turnovers.
You mentioned 8 turnovers for Lutheran in the first half. I think you had mentioned he had 5 of them through the first 6 minutes of the first quarter, so they did a much better job the second quarter and clean up their play a little bit. We're off and running here in the second half. Mike Martin along with Chris Wright bringing you the ball game. Shot that time is no good by Ladwig. Juris forgot to put the ball down first.
Leading scorer for Kohler is Tyler Lewis on the season, but he's been very quiet. Just 1 of 5 from the floor, Marty.
He hit a 3 early on, and then he was pretty silent the rest of the way. He did come up with 3 points after that. But
completely silent.
Yeah, he had 2 free throws in the second quarter, but that's it. No more baskets. Ladwig's shot is no good. Juris tipped it away from the Blue Bomber, James Miesfeldt. Sheely doing the dirty work underneath, but couldn't get it. Lewis with the eventual rebound. Miesfeldt's shot, no good. And Sheely down on the other end to grab another rebound. He's working hard. Ball's going to go on Brennan Ladwig, his second. Phil Lightbaum right in front of us throwing it in. I'm the good looking one right below the monitor. Kick out. 3-point shot is no good by Lightbaum. His first miss from 3-point land. A slow start to the second half was pretty much scoring in the first half, at least for the Crusaders, 42 points.
Yeah, they're averaging 64 a game. Kohler just 49.
Dominic Bocchini looking to go down the lane. Pretty good defense played by Juris there. Shot no good. Sheely got the rebound, almost threw it away. I think he got away with an over-the-back foul, Chris. Juris from outside the line. His three-pointer is no good.
Wow, that's his first shot attempt, Marty. And he's averaging 14.
Yeah, I was going to say he averages in double figures. I knew that. Case got away with a carry. His shot was blocked by Ben Lightbaum. And he kicks it over to Zastro for an easy layup.
Once again, the shot selection from Kohler, not the best. How do you think he was going to make that there?
Dominic Bocchini under control, bringing it up. Case off a screen, his shot is no good. Zastro has it, trying to run the break. Gets it in the Juris, who tried to get it over the Sheely, but was stolen away by Lewis. He's going to score, Chris.
Now 2 of 8 from the floor, Lewis.
Zastro throws it up and it just wouldn't quite roll in, but he does get fouled. He'll be shooting 2.
Once again, they let him go left, Marty.
Yeah, you don't want to do that. Didn't North have a guy that was left-handed? They kept letting him go left last year.
Devin Yerk? I never mentioned that, did I? Well, I don't know. I don't know.
Sometimes it's easier said than done. I mean, you can talk about it and practice it and, you know, attempt to do it, and sometimes they're just better than you, that's all.
Then you find somebody that can force them right.
Dominic Bocchini being guarded by Zastro. And he's going to get a ticky-tack. Oy, oy, oy.
Well, you got to call it. You know, he put his hand in there and kind of grabbed after he was beat. He played good D and then was beaten, then grabbed.
Lead. 45-29. Lutheran on top. Been a lot of runs in this game, Chris. I was looking at that at halftime. Lutheran had 2 11-point runs, both of them in the first quarter.
Yeah, I mentioned that to Tom Keyes at half, too. So that's a game of runs. I said, yep, Marty had two 11s
for Lutheran, and With the score 36-17, Kohler down by 19. They went on a 10-point run, forced Lutheran to call a timeout.
Since then, Kohler's only has 2 points.
That's right. So another run. Rolling down to the 4-minute mark. Ball is tipped away. Too much dribbling that time by Bucchini. Phil Lightbaum scores, and he's fouled off a great pass from Jeff Juris. That was sweet. You get the replay machine working tonight? That'd be a good one to see again. Falls on Noah Fink.
Phil, 4 of 4, all twos.
Oh, missed a free throw.
Bad.
47-29. Whoa. Good defense by Ben Lightbaum.
Cheating.
That's what happens when you're tall. Essen Hasenstein in. H squared. Taylor Zastro also in the ball game. And Jacob Ames. Dominic Bocchini looking for the steal, but all he could do is tap it out of bounds. Hess taking it down the baseline, got it up off the window, but couldn't get it in. And then Connor Hogan had his hand in. But they're going to call a foul on Taylor Zastro.
Go 47-29. Bad place to give up your dribble, Dominic.
3 minutes left in the quarter. Shot by Lewis is no good, and then he's called for the offensive foul.
Blue bomber foul, 13, Tyler Lewis. Second personal, 14.
Kohler starting to apply some full court pressure. And Zastro throws it away. Layup attempt by Hogan is missed. Kohler's missed several layup attempts tonight.
Yes, they have.
Hasenstein inside to Ames. He misses a layup.
Oh, boy.
Don't you kind of aim for that spot on the wind, on the glass, you know, and bank it off of there to make it go in? That's fifth grade stuff. Nice pass from Bocchini into Hogan for an easy two. Jacob Ames not able to handle that pass, but he does get it in the corner. Then we get a timeout by Lutheran, a 30-second timeout. Let's talk a little bit about the Division I brackets. We mentioned North plays South. The winner of that game plays the winner of Lincoln and Bayport. And I was looking at the seedings, Chris, and Manitowoc's a sixth seed, but then I looked at the bracket. They're splitting it up. They've only got 9 teams in that bracket.
Yeah, there's 9 teams. Well, with 5 divisions now, it's completely changed everything, and there's less teams, and you also got that super sectional. You only have 4 teams that go to state, which is really
different.
Well, I think it's just a travesty. You got all the big schools. You know, they have the most population. And
but in a way, when you think about it, you know, the number one and number two divisions are going to be much bigger than 3, 4, and 5, and they're still going to get 8 teams. And trouble is, it won't be one tournament. It'll be 2 separate ones.
Right, but it's, you know, that's normally where you get some of the better players. Obviously, Sam was the exception to the rule last year. But
you want to know something, Chris? Change is hard.
Well, yeah. But I don't like diluting champions either. What do we need 5 champions for?
Yeah, exactly. Let's give out another gold ball.
We got
Getting a little ragged at 47-31 with 1:35 left in the third. And Division 5, we mentioned Lutheran will be playing Oneida Nation. Ames down the lane, scores.
Well, that's what Lutheran did in the first quarter, layup after layup after layup after layup. And
you know, and the road is still there right down Main Street like that. Shot outside the line. Pancake shot by Fink is no good. Under a minute. Oh, boy. Hasenstein broke open underneath the basket, but Zastro needs to work on his passing. Phil Lightbaum, 30 seconds left. Whoops.
17 seconds.
Yeah, Miller got clocked in the mouth, and Ames again missing a bunny shot. Zastro tries to put it up and in. They're going to call a tie-up, and possession arrow points Lutheran's way with 9.1 seconds remaining. Shealy coming back in. You like him, Chris.
Oh,
he's got a big body. Boy, look at him in the chest and the shoulders. He's a strong kid.
He's got 12 rebounds, and we got a quarter to go.
I think he's in the honors weightlifting class. Over at Salt High. Five, four, Hess. Oh, in and out. Long shot at the buzzer is no good by Connor Hogan. We're at the end of three. Lutheran on top, 49-31.
I can have text all night long, but not when I'm driving.
What's the point of texting me about a party that you might not make it to?
I don't text and drive.
Do you?
Do you?
Do you?
Did you say text or sex? Hey, I got an idea. As long as you're texting, why don't you write your own obituary, dumb?
I don't
text and drive.
Do you?
We don't text and drive. Do you?
Brought to you by Rad Terry Vader and his cast of thousands. Friends don't let friends text and drive.
Party!
Did you know early signs of eye disease and vision changes start to occur around age 40? I'm Dr. Ann Coleman for the American Academy of Ophthalmology. I see firsthand how vision problems can affect lives. We are urging adults to get a baseline eye disease screening at age 40. If you have any risk factors or signs of eye disease, see an ophthalmologist right away. Know your risks. Save your sight. To learn more, visit GetEyeSmart.org.
Lutheran in the ballgame had 23 in the first quarter, 17 in the second, but only 9 in the third. Kohler had 13, 14, and only 4 in the third. Zastro trying to save it. And we get another jump ball situation. Saders will get it back. Getting a little ragged, Chris. Gets like that when you're not shooting very well. The teams are missing layups, both of them left and right. Sheely's shot is misses everything. Case has it. Inside feed, kick out. And the shot is no good by Miller. Zastro got the shot off, but he was fouled. Zastro has 13 points.
Kohler just 12 of 35 from the floor. Well under 30%. Lutheran's they're not much better now. They've really cooled off. They were at 66. They're just over 50%, or they're at 50% right now.
Zastro is only 4 of 7 from the line, Chris, free throw shooting. He does have 14 points, though.
I like the skip pass, but they got to shoot it earlier.
Miller's shot is off. Into Sheely, who lays it up and in off a great pass from Tyler Zastro.
I like that kid.
Sheely runs the floor well, too. Phil taps it off of Ladwig's foot. And Lutheran will get it back. They're on top, 52-31. Juris on a feed back to Ben Lightbaum. His shot is up and in. Are they going to count it? Or are they going to say he was on the floor? Hogan commits a foul, no basket. Juris going baseline, kicks it over to Sheely, who puts it up and in. Another nice pass by Jeff Juris. Lutheran playing like a team, Chris.
5 of 13 for Sheely from the floor.
Case with a wild shot, had no chance.
Now they just don't get good looks.
Zastro with a 10-footer, put it up and in. That looks sweet. 56-31. With 6:02 remaining in the ball game, Kohler calls another timeout. It's a full timeout, so let's take a short break, Kerry.
Did you know early signs of eye disease and vision changes start to occur around age 40? I'm Dr. Ann Coleman for the American Academy of Ophthalmology. I see firsthand how vision problems can affect lives. We are urging adults to get a baseline eye disease screening at age 40. If you have any risk factors or signs of eye disease, see an ophthalmologist right away. Know your risks. Save your sight. To learn more, visit geteyesmart.org.
There you see Nick Verhagen talking to the troops. They're working on all cylinders now, Chris. They look pretty good, and talk about a run. 2, 4, 6, 8, 9. I was wrong before. It's a 9-point run. They scored the last 2 points of the third quarter, and now they've run off 7 in this quarter. Make it another run in a game of runs. Tyler, I don't think you need to press him anymore. Case has it. Ball was tipped in the backcourt. Miller loaded it up, had a pretty good look, but couldn't get it in. Ben Lightbaum.
Oh, wow.
Tried to get it over to Zastro. I think they all were yelling at him to dunk it. And the shirts across the way, those bright yellow shirts, say, Ben, just dunk it. So I'm sure he was thinking about it. Phil Lightbaum comes out. Coming in for the Crusaders is Eric Puksic. A nice move in the lane, but the shot wouldn't drop for Noah Fink. Hogan got the rebound, and then Lewis is fouled on the shot attempt.
Crusader call on 3, Jake Juris. Second personal.
Juris commits the foul.
Kohler just 2 of 17 in the half, Marty.
Yeah, they've struggled for sure. Lewis, the leading scorer for the Blue Bombers, has 7 points.
It's 2 of 8 from the floor.
Okay, you get a good shot of Tyler Lewis. See, he didn't know he was on camera. Then he figured it out, finally scored. Zastrow, good use of the body, but still had his shot blocked.
He's 6 of 9, Tyler, tonight.
Yeah, he's had a nice night. Every once in a while he throws a pass that I don't care for, but for the most part he's played a pretty complete game. Worked very hard on defense, that's for sure. Okay, it's the smallest guy on the floor, runs in and gets the offensive rebound. Coach is not happy about that. Calvin Stefancic coming in. There were some other Stefancics that played a couple of years ago were pretty good ball players. Calvin is a 6 foot junior. And it looks like a 2-2-1 zone press by the Bombers. And wide open is Juris. He's fouled and he makes the basket.
His first basket of the night, Marty.
Could be a 3-point play. Ozenstein, Hess, and Taylor Zastrow all at the table waiting to come in.
Blue Bomber foul, 24 fouls. Sabacek, first personal, 18 foul. At the line to complete the 3-point play.
Juris makes the free throw for the 3-point play. It's 59-32, 4:29 left in the ball game. Taylor Zastrow, Hess, Ozenstein, Ben Lipum, and Puksic in the ball game for the Crusaders. Wow, Zastrow's going to get called for a foul. I think he breathed on him. Can't breathe on him, Taylor. Jacob Ames coming in, and he wanted to get Ben Lipum to come out all by himself so he could get a deserved round of applause from the fans. Ladwig's shot in the lane is no good. Ames with the rebound. Going to call Hess with a foul. Lewis took a shot to the chin or the face. Stefancic's shot is no good. Ames with a rebound. They may be coasting home from here, Chris. Neither team looks real intense anymore.
Well, Kohler's missed every shot here in the quarter, and they are 2 of 20, 10%.
Ouch. Hey, that's pretty good math, man. At 10%? Holy cow.
10% in the second half.
Shooting 1-1. Jeff Hess. 15, Joe Pawlowski reports for the...
Joe Pawlowski coming in for the Bombers, making his first appearance. Jeff Hess is at the line shooting.
Justin Welsh for Lutheran as well, Marty. Shouldn't have let those guys... Oh, I guess it was bonus, huh?
Oh, that's right. Justin Welsh, right, number 22 in. Thank you, Chris. We'll make sure we get everybody's name mentioned. Hess with a 1-for-2 trip, 60-32. Case has it. Stefanchek. Oh, he hit the rim that time.
Oh, they get a reload.
Clock rolling down to the 3 minute mark of the ball game. Gladwick gets it inside. Shot is no good. Hess with the rebound right over the top of Case. And Philip Case commits his third foul. Hess will be the line again.
At the line to shoot two. Yes.
10th team foul on the Bombers, so Hess will get a pair.
Turris
coming in. And Greg Sirlik. Sirlik is 43. Turris is 14. That's with a 2-for-2 trip. Makes it a 30-point game, 62-32. Case. It's off the front of the rim. And then it goes off of Hess's foot. Cody Gartman comes in. He's a 6'3 junior. Cody's number 44. Seeing his first action of the night. Turris trying to run the old back door. A little too much congestion in there. Stefanchek from 8 off the glass. No good. I think their percentage is below 10%, no?
They're 0 of 13 in the quarter.
Ouch.
2 of 24 and a half.
They are 1 for 2 from the free throw line, though. Spin into the lane. Shot up and in by Justin Welsh.
Nice baby hook.
Yeah, it was. Nice move into the lane. Turris right through the crowd, lays it up and off. Pawlowski, that was. Pawlowski with the nice drive. Missed a shot. He'd be shooting a pair. Well, the free throw shooting has not been real good this quarter either. 1 for 3.
Well, he got it. Shot it right back in there.
Ozenstein has it.
All right, Weave here. Run some clock.
You want to tell that referee to move? He's right in my way. Hess pull up from 12. Bango. He's got 5 in the game. 66-33. They've doubled up on him with 1:25 left in the game.
Make one.
Stefanchek can't buy a basket. Turris can't buy a basket. And Welsh comes away with the loose ball. Good hustle. Good hustle by Justin, Chris.
Under a minute.
Puksic. Luther. Welsh wanted it inside, but they weren't going to throw it in there.
Say Kohler's gonna fall to 8-14.
Puksic for 3! Bombs away! Oh, baby. That was pretty sweet. Gartman couldn't get it. Stefanchek couldn't get it. Layup attempt by Pawlowski is no good. Could it be, Chris? No baskets in the quarter, only 2 free throws. Ozzie's going to pull it out. I don't think they're going to shoot anymore. 10 seconds left.
Shooting in the quarter.
And and that's the ball game. Lutheran a winner in their final game of the season. Regular season game at 69-33. I'm going to figure out some scoring for you. Chris is going to go see if he can get a couple interviews. We'll take a short break and be right back.
Are you connected?
If you don't have access to internet, you aren't going to be able to take advantage of anything.
The internet is essential to the basics in life, housing, healthcare, employment.
I personally benefited from broadband because I was able to fill out different applications, and I'm pretty positive that I'll get another job.
To get connected, call 866-765-9118 or visit changeyourtomorrow.org.
If everyone had access to the internet, people's lives would be changed.
Connect today. Change your tomorrow.
I assess the needs of a community to make sure that our work will be sustainable.
We are working to change the world to make it a better place.
Through our sustainable engineering projects, thousands of members in more than 225 universities and professional chapters work to support these efforts in over 45 countries.
To find out more about how you can get involved, go to www.ewb-usa.org and click Get Involved.
Build a better world with us.
Build a better world with us.
Build a better world with us, one community at a time.
In Wisconsin, the laws are the same for bicyclists and motorists. So if you bike, ride with the traffic and obey stop signs and lights. Whether you ride a bike or drive a car, you must yield the right-of-way to pedestrians at marked and unmarked crosswalks. At intersections, always look for pedestrians before making a turn. And slow down in school zones and neighborhoods to keep our kids safe. Share and be aware. We're all responsible.
Cable access channels ensure you the ability to exercise your First Amendment rights through the medium of television. They create opportunities for mutual communication, education, and artistic expression. Public access makes community participation possible and gives you a voice in your community and your world. Make sure everyone has a voice. Support your local public access channel.
It's not over. Japan still needs our help. This is not yesterday's news. It's happening now. This is Japan now. Let's help.
By a score of 69-33. In the fourth quarter, Lutheran scored 20. Kohler only two on 2-for-4 from the free throw line. They really had trouble shooting the ball late in the ball game. One more time, Lutheran a winner, 69-33. That makes Lutheran now 15-7 on the year. They finish in second place in the conference, 13-3. Kohler ends up with an 8-14 regular season record, 4-12 in conference. Leading scorers for Kohler, they were led by Brendan Ladwig with 9 points. Their leading scorer, Tyler Lewis, finished with 8. For Lutheran, Jacob Ames had 6, Jacob Juris 3, Ryan Sheely had 12, Nate Hosenstein and Jeff Hess with 5 each, Eric Puksich with a late 3 for 3 points, Justin Welsh with a late 2 for 2 points, Phil Leipom had 8. Leading all scorers was Tyler Zastrow with 16 points. And on senior night, the lone senior on the Crusader squad, Ben Leipom, finished with 9 points, played a real nice game. In tournament action, we mentioned Lutheran will face Oneida Nation in the first round, while Kohler will be playing Sheboygan Christian. Those games will happen on Tuesday night. Our next game, we'll be covering the Sheboygan North, Sheboygan South game next Friday in the first round of tournament action. The winner of that game will play the winner of Manitowoc, Lincoln, and Bayport. With the win tonight, WSCS runs their regular season record to 13-3. For the crew, Kerry Kautzer, our director, Eric Wiesman, and Richard Bartson, the cameraman. For my partner, Chris Wright, I'm Mike Martin saying thanks for watching, everybody, and we'll see you down the road.